Let's read the let's read the part before the highlighted portion. By exploring the Russian food that existed before potatoes, Sarenkov hopes to help Russians reacquaint themselves with the country's agrarian roots and to convince them that their national cuisine can be just as flavorful as anything they might find in a sushi bar. He spends his time traveling through the countryside in search of old recipes, trying them himself and blogging about his experiences. Often he is brought in as a consultant on projects to make a restaurant authentically Russian. Recently, he hatched a plan for a user-generated database of folk recipes. My idea is to send out a call all across Russia, he told me. If you have a grandmother who makes shashinsky, dish-shaped pastries, take a picture of them, write down the recipe. To me, it's absolutely obvious that if we don't wake up and find out from these old women and set it down on paper, in 20 years we won't have anyone to ask. Russian culture will lose a very significant part of itself. So from this we can see that his activity is mainly highlighted to emphasize how dedicated he is to help Russia discover their culinary roots and how he wants to preserve the recipes. And how he wants them to know that their own food can be just as flavorful as other food. Hence, we choose option B.